I will conclude this subunit on computational methods for solving differential equations with some more general remarks. So we've been discussing Euler's method. Euler's method is known as a numerical or computational method for solving a differential equation. It's computational because it involves doing computations using almost always a computer. And it's called numerical, that's its maybe more traditional term, because the result of Euler's method is not a formula for a function, but it's a list of numbers. So we call it a numerical method. Euler's method is quite simple conceptually, and it gets at the heart of what differential equations are. A rule for how something changes, and that rule is written in terms of the derivative, the rate of change, not the function itself. So I think if you understand Euler's method and maybe code it up yourself, then you really have a good understanding of what differential equations mean. So I definitely recommend, if you have some programming skills, the language doesn't matter at all and you can use a spreadsheet, to try coding up Euler's method yourself. I'll list this in the homework for this unit. So Euler's method is very nice conceptually, however, it's not very efficient computationally. So it's not used much in practice. Let me say a little bit about how one can improve on Euler's method. So to improve on Euler's method, there are two things one might like to do. First, there's a family of techniques, a group of techniques known as Runge-Kutta methods. And here's the idea behind them. I'm not going to go into this in details, but it's worth mentioning. So in Euler's method, we pretend that the rate of change is constant over an interval delta t, and then we have to choose what rate of change we're going to use, and we just choose the rate of change at the left part of that interval. We just take the starting rate of change in that interval and pretend that it's constant for all of delta t. Runge-Kutta methods say, well, rather than using the rate of change at the start of the interval, what if we use the rate of change at the start of the interval and at the end of the interval and average those two? That would probably be a more fairer representation of what's happening in that interval. Or better still, maybe we could sample the rate of change at three different points along that interval. And there are different schemes for doing that sampling and different ways of averaging the different derivatives that one estimates. But that's the general idea. Rather than just use one derivative, sample a couple derivatives, and average those. So that's one way to improve on Euler's method. It's not immediately obvious, but this turns out to be more efficient in the sense that with less computational effort, you can get an equally accurate answer. The other thing that one typically does is something called adaptive step size. And this is, you have the program automatically adjust delta t on the fly as it's trying to find the solution. So delta t needs to be small when the derivative is changing rapidly. We get into trouble with these methods when we pretend the derivative is constant over delta t, but it actually changes a lot. So if we have a situation where sometimes, as time goes on, the derivative is changing rapidly, and other times it's not changing rapidly, then we don't need to use the same delta t. If the change in derivative is slow, we can use a large delta t. When it's fast, we need to use a small delta t. And so these adaptive step size methods figure that out on the fly. I sort of think about it, adaptive step sizes this way, and this is a rough analogy, but it maybe gives the right idea. Imagine you're walking across a landscape and you're blindfolded, you can't see. If the landscape is flat, you can take very big steps and you're not going to miss anything, but if the landscape is very bumpy, then you'll need to take small steps to make sure you don't trip or miss something. So if you're blindfolded, you might adjust your step size depending on what you sense the terrain to be. Okay, in any event, the standard way to improve on Euler's method is to do these two things, some type of Runge-Kutta method and some type of adaptive step size. Almost all numerical programming environments that I'm familiar with, MATLAB, Octave, Maple, Mathematica, Python, have some sort of built-in Runge-Kutta adaptive step size solver. So perhaps in the forum, some of you who have experience with these different things and maybe have solved differential equations before can post some examples for how to use these different built-in functions. Okay, lastly, let me just take a look ahead. So in the next units, I'll be frequently presenting solutions to differential equations, and almost always the solutions that I present and show you and discuss will be numerical solutions. In order to do this course, you don't need to solve differential equations on your own. You don't need to code up your own algorithms. You don't need to use other people's algorithms. However, I think it's important that you have a sense of where these numerical solutions come from. So if I show you a solution to a differential equation, you have some idea where that solution came from. It's not magic. It's just from using something like Euler's method, a very simple but repetitive way of solving differential equations.